So, hi everybody. Today we are going to learn the official 10 throwing steps for vertical form.
Yay.
Vertical meaning it goes up like this, it's not a bowl like that. Okay? Alright, so we're going to learn how to make that on the wheel, the 10 steps. Alright, so you're going to start with some clay. Now this clay here has got some problems if you are going to use it on the wheel.
It's wet?
Yes.
Oh, it hasn't been
wedged. It hasn't been wedged, exactly. Yeah. Wedged, so it needs to be wedged to make it not so that it doesn't have air bubbles, so those aren't really helpful.
So colors drying the wet clay are mixed.
Exactly, so that it's consistent. Because if you have inconsistent clay on the pottery wheel,
it's going to
come out all uneven. And if you're learning to control the clay, then that doesn't help. Okay, so you can point down here. And I'm going to wedge as quickly as possible.
Would there be certain instances when you like kind of want it to look like it is kind of upside down?
Yes. In fact, I love putting unwedged clay on my wheel, but I already know how to control it. So when I use that as a creative option, that's a great thing. So basically, everybody give me your fist. Okay, how much does this weigh?
Maybe five ounces-ish.
I think you probably are close on your hand. Mine's a, if it was clay, it would be about a pound.
Okay.
So I need you to go to the wheel with, when you are gonna do this, with 3 1-pound spheres that are wedged. So I'm weighing these. 1 pound makes about a mug. You know, like those dining hall mugs? So I've got one, see?
Some are actually.
Okay, so I am making this not into a taco, not into a longhorn.
New ball.
Yes, a sphere. Mm-hmm. Right there. Okay, so how many do I need?
Three.
I do need three. It's, if I was in my own studio at home, I might make 3 mugs in a row. I usually make a bunch at once. But here, if I was learning, the reason I would have 3 is in case one messed up, I have some just sitting there. I don't even have to get up and go looking for clay and wedge it and all that stuff. It's already taken care of. Oops. Okay, so there I have 3. All right, so then you're gonna need, this time you're gonna need a round bat. Okay? So this one is round and it's sort of level. Okay? You're gonna want one that is kind of on the flat side. Not one that's real wrinkled or something. And they're good bats over there, but they get a little bit wrinkled sometimes from like objects sitting on them when they're drying. So this one's pretty flat, so I like it. These are called bat pins. Sometimes if one's missing, then that's a problem. You can ask me to find another one, I have plenty. All right, so in this studio, our system is you use a bat on the wheel, and that way when you make a project and it's too delicate to move, you can lift the whole bat and take it to your shelf. See? Okay. All right. So, 10 steps. All right, let me borrow your paper for a second. In your paper, borrow your pencil, you're gonna make a big T like this. T for Texas, T for Tennessee. Do you see that? It's not a longhorn exactly. But what this is a representation of this pottery wheel with the bat on it.
Oh.
You're gonna keep making them all the way in all of your things. So you're going to do air pottery of these 10 steps, and then you are going to draw down and write the name of the step. I'm sorry if I smudged. Okay. Ready to learn the first step?
Yes.
Lose the pieces of paper. Yeah, get rid of them. Get rid of it. Yeah.
Okay, well, since my right foot's injured and I'm down with my right
foot. Oh, you can drive with your left. Yeah, you can totally. I changed my driving foot. Yeah, you can move the foot pedal. That's the beautiful thing about this brand of wheels. You can move this anywhere that's comfortable for you.
Okay.
Even you can put this up on blocks and stand and throw. It's really nice. Okay. So, all right, so I am getting my bat a little bit wet, but not shiny wet, not slippery wet. It's just dry enough to get a lot of this dust down. I'm going to hold this sphere here. I'm going to smack it in the middle. Did I get it very good? Not really impressive. No, no. But it is stuck. That's good news. Oh, okay. So that's more in the middle. So did you see I used momentum to adhere my clay? Okay, and then I'm making it go around like pie crust. You see I'm pie crusting it? All right. Everybody take your elbows and put them on your knees. Now overlap your fingers like this with straight wrists. Excellent. Your wrists are bent. Yeah, there you go.
Like this?
That is pretty good. More like that.
Like this?
Yep, perfect. Fingers together. Mm-hmm. Perf. Let me see. I can't see yours. Yours are good. Excellent. A little too vertical. 45 degree angle. Overlap fingers. You get more strength that way. Excellent. Okay. Watch. I'm getting this a little bit slick. Do you see that? Shiny? Slick?
Shiny.
Yeah. All right. So, I know it sounds funny. Okay. 45 degrees. Straight wrists. Pulling this way.
Oh.
I know. It centers so fast. Okay. Take your two thumbs. Put them on top. Push down. Down, down, down. Can you do this, please? Thank you. Put your feet on the floor.
Oh,
what?
Can
you like cut that in half?
It'll just be like kind of like a snow cone. Okay, so
is
this.
Is the only not satisfying?
I like it.
It kind of hurts when you scratch your hand on like the board if
the
it's
grit.
Not super wet.
Yeah, yeah, the grit can kind of get you. Okay, so this is centering. This is coning up. Okay, and so here I am, and now I'm coning back down to centering. Okay, so here is your goal. Are you ready?
Easy.
This is how the pros do it. First they center. Can you point it at that?
Should we
break
this?
In a minute. Then you cone up, then you center, then you cone up, then you center, then we're going to step three. Can you draw down steps one and two on your paper?
That looks so cool.
Alright. Whoa.
You can just
put
it like that.
Mm-hmm. So here's a quiz. What step goes before step three?
Cutting.
Centering.
Right. Centering.
Which is
centering.
Step?
Centering.
Step one.
Step one, centering, exactly.
Step one, step two, centering.
So, right. So that's why I say three times, that's why I say two times. So, One time. Bam, step
three.
We'll talk.
Whoa, that's such a cool thing you did on the back.
Oh, yeah, it looks
like
spin art.
It's really pretty how it has that tiny little, dot. Because sometimes when you make, certain shapes, it looks like those really cool, art effects. There's these pots that kind of look like that.
Yes, like some sort of ancient, historical pot.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay, are you ready for step three?
Yeah.
Lose the papers. Take your two thumbs. Point them down and put them back to back. Anchor your elbows on your legs. Elbow bones connected to the knee bone. Okay. Okay, so back to back thumbs. Can you see? Can you see also? You can. Can you? Just a bit, just kind of, I don't know, rotate maybe? Can you see? Kind of? Okay. Okay, see, I'm drilling. So I am drilling down. Do you see I have two back to back? And I'm on my knees.
It's so shiny.
I am drilling down. And then I'm leaving it all the way. No, I'll show you. Then I go this far down from the bat. So I leave this much clay, so I'm leaving a floor. And then my thumbs go like this. Apart, 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 apart. Do you see it?
Well, how do you know?
Apart.
How do you know how close you are to the bottom?
You have to intuit. There, we do have our special secret ways, but I'm not going to show you that right now. Okay.
Whoa.
Okay. Do you see? I'm apart, 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 apart. So I did step three, drilling down. Step four, flat floor. Something is completely done on your pot. It's the floor. you're finished. It's all done. Taken care of. No more messing we're thinking about the floor. Completed.
Complete.
Yeah. Alright.
Done.
Alright, so step three, step four, draw it. She said as she redid her floor. I remodeled. I just recently remodeled my floor. My flooring. I changed it out.
For step four platform, you don't go all the way to the floor, right?
You don't go to the bat. You leave this much clay and you glide across.
Like a quarter inch.
Quarter inch. Mm-hmm.
Like otherwise it would just.
Oh, do we name that?
Yeah.
Yes, name it. Step four flat floor. That's a great name for that one. You could always pick a different name that you like. That would also be acceptable. I like it. I like your drawing.
Oh, darts, I forgot to draw this.
That's okay. You can redraw it. You got an eraser that works. Okay. Get your flat floor going. Okay, you ready? Step five?
Mm-hmm.
This is the easy, fun one. Elbow bones connected to the
knee bones.
Good. Okay. You just grab from the outside and you angle it in. So there's a volcano. And you have a volcano. All right, step five, volcano. Are you ready for step six?
Yep. Wait, oh, I love this step.
Should we draw it yet? Okay.
I love this step.
Step six, yes.
Pulling it off.
Are you?
Oh, this is fun.
A beast at step six. Okay, so step six. Give me your two hands. Hook your thumbs. Give me Napoleon Dynamite. No, don't do that. No. Okay, give me this. Two hands. Hook your thumbs. Touch your fingers. Open your fingers a little bit. All right, this is a pair, show me your pliers. Pliers, okay.
They make noises.
Now.
Yes, they do.
All right, your pliers, your left hand is going to sacrifice itself inside the volcano. No! Okay, anyway, it goes in there. So the left hand is in the middle. I am biting white with pliers. Am I like this?
No.
I'm like this. Everybody give me this.
It's like a squirrel.
Go up and to the left. Good. Why to the left, you say? It's because our wheel's going this way. It's going counterclockwise. That's the way we have to go to be dragging with our clay. Okay, so you ready? Up and to the left.
That's really satisfying.
It's really satisfying.
That should be in like a
okay. All right, so I don't do this once, but I do it three times. Three's that magic number.
Oh, yeah,
that's
three.
No.
Seven.
Yes, it is.
Okay, here we are. So, did you see I got it slick again?
Slick.
Okay.
Pretty slick.
Okay.
Where's it
biting?
Going?
I've got my biting pliers. Okay, my hand is in the middle.
It is?
Well, yeah.
It's
round.
Well, it was
now
for
it
a second.
Was.
It was.
Your hands were in it.
Oh. Yeah.
It's so beautiful.
Okay, so I get three chances on this. Most professionals pull up something, whatever they're making, whatever vertical form it is, in three pulls. They have a round three.
I see that.
Okay, so if for some reason you mess it all up, you have ribs. Well, sometimes they don't come out this straight and even. So this will work to fix it, and this, the credit card hotel key thing, will work. Watch. Oh. So where's my elbow? Step seven, elbow down. All right, and this hand? Goes on the inside and helps out its friend on the other side of the wall.
Are we making
okay.
Like
a cup? Huh?
Are we making like a
cup?
It could be a cup, it could be a vase, something that's vertical.
I need a vase.
What if you want it to be shorter?
Huh? If you want it to be shorter, then use less clay, make it wider from the beginning. You can change the dimensions, but these are the steps you use, even if it's shorter and wider.
So what are you making
okay.
right now?
What I'm making is a vase.
What steps do you
yeah.
do different
okay.
for not vertical?
Huh?
What steps do you do different for not vertical?
You can leave out a whole bunch of these. Like you make a hole and then you just pull up if you're doing a bowl,
oh,
for example.
Yeah.
If you're doing a plate, you go from there down to, I don't know, it's just different. If you're making a cup, you do this. Okay, so how many times did I pull it up already?
Three.
Did I?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay,
no,
well,
two.
I think two-ish. I'm going to give myself, I'm only squeezing down here because that's the only place there's clay. Some of it came off. Okay, what's after pulling up?
Ribbing.
All right.
It makes a little smooth.
Yes, it does. Okay, now I'm going to have you draw it all down. Draw it down.
It's a 15-minute video.
Okay, so far. Yeah, it'll be, I need to stop soon. You can pause it if you want.
So are we going to do this today?
Everybody lose the papers.
No, I'm not doing it yet.
Okay. Go quickly, my young Padawan.
You guys are doing elaborate drawings.
Yeah. Okay. So, we have made it. We've ribbed. We have a cylinder.
Ribs.
Okay. So, number 8, water out. So, there's usually some kind of water and slurry on the inside, which if you leave it there, if you leave a puddle in there, and this dries out, and this has a puddle in it, what's going to happen? Right. It's going to kind of... It's going to recycle. It's going to be mush here and dry there. You'll have like a cylinder that's raggedy, that's mush. Okay, so you get the water out. So this is your water out aid. So got the water, bringing it over here. Okay, so the water's all out. I might have to do that twice. Don't even put it down. Turn it over. Put the long side right in front of you, elbows in. All right, and I am just driving it underneath the pot right there. And so you are creating a visual separation of the object that you are making from the bat.
If you did like small ones, like all the way up, it would create a really great pattern.
Like that?
Yeah.
Ooh, stripies. Yeah, you could do that also. And then if you change your mind, can always rib it.
Wow.
Okay.
Ribbit.
So,
like an eraser.
Okay.
Ribbit.
So, we have done step 8 and 9. Now, step 10, shaping. This is the step I don't want you to do on day 1 or 2, but you can work your way up. So, shaping. All wide things. I just shadowed. Did you miss it?
No.
Okay. I was going to say, I'm going to post it on the interwebs. So look, so even if you want to make something really wide and round and with a thick lip, again, I just did. Do it again.
Like all the way over?
I don't know. This clay's going to run out. It's pretty thin up here.
So pretty.
Okay, so basically I'm showing you that even if you, this is the shape you want, first you pull up. Like this. Okay? I just got a little extra water in there. Alright, then, once you're done shaping it,
cut it off the bottom.
I'm going to cut it off the bottom. Alright. So I'm doing this. Alright. So did you see how I did it? Tight with my hands like this, pulling pretty darn hard.
That looks painful.
No.
It's fine.
Like you're flossing.
All the way down.
It's like flossing. Mm-hmm. It's exactly like flossing.
And go all the way down to the bottom.
Right.
So you don't
do it all loose like this. That's bad. Okay. So then you can just take it off or you can just remove the whole bat. Here's your goal. Are you ready?
What are you doing?
I am demonstrating what you want. So the goal is a very thin, even wall here. There's my flat floor. This got a little thin there. This is a little thicker there, but the goal is a very even wall throughout. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Again.
Okay. All right. So that is how we do that.
That was so sad.